very good friend of mine called to tell me that her mother was coming to visit. Her mother is in her 80s. She said that her niece was about to deliver a baby, and just as her mother arrived, the baby arrived. It was a joyous moment for them. And then last night, little Samuel stopped breathing. Everybody was in panic. They called for emergency services and they were able to get little Samuel breathing again, but found out that his blood sugar had dropped below 10. And so now he's in the hospital as they try to normalize his metabolism. In the Stokes and Moore family, a young man is in crisis this morning in the hospital, but hopefully will come home later today. Some of you have your own individual crises. Maybe it's your husband, maybe it's your wife, maybe it's one of your children, perhaps it's the employer, or maybe you are the employer and it's your employee. But I'd like to invite you to come down here with me before the throne of God today and bring with you your petitions. I'd like to encourage you to take a step of faith today and come and ask God for that anointing I know He wants to give you. I invite you to just step forward, press in close, get as close to me as you can, and make room for you. Bring your husband, bring your wife, bring your son, bring your daughter. Come and spend just a little moment with us in this season of prayer. Come today. Jesus, no, not one, none else can heal all the earth's diseases. No, not one. Jesus is a friend who loves me in spite of my difficulties. Jesus is a father when all has gone wrong and I find myself alone. Jesus is a brother who sticks by me and supports me. Jesus is a mother who nurtures me and cares for me. Jesus is a savior who has come to buy back my salvation for me. Jesus is a deliverer who fulfills his word, his promise. Jesus is a king who reigns and rules. Jesus is worthy to be celebrated. I will magnify the Lord at all times. His praises shall continually be in my mouth. Jesus is my God, my Savior. He is my deliverer. Father in heaven, thank you for Jesus. Thank you that He came. Thank you that He lived. Thank you that He died. But thank you that He rose again. And more than that, thank you that He is coming again. The songwriter said, lift up the trumpet and loud let it ring. Jesus is coming again. This prayer of intercession today is meant to be an instrument of help and hope for those who find themselves in hopeless situations. This prayer today is meant to be a reminder that if we confess our sins, He will be faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. This prayer today is meant to be a reminder that He's our rock, our sword, our shield, our wheel in the middle of a wheel. That He is our bread when we are hungry. He is our water when we are thirsty. He's our shelter when we are homeless. He's our garment when we are naked. He is the way above all ways. Today we celebrate Jesus. We lift up before you now the young people who are responsible for our worship today. We lift up before you the young man who will speak your words to us today. May they be words of help. May they be words of hope. May they be words of encouragement. We lift up before you today our school, our students. We are passing. passing through a stormy season. Yeah. But Lord God, you are a water walking God.
Yeah.
You are a storm quieting God. Yeah. You are a fire cooling God. Yeah. You can do anything and everything. And so we pray for our school. We pray for our students. We pray for our parents. Help us, Lord God, to know that the storm is passing over. The storm is passing over. Hallelujah. 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 Today, Father, we want to pray for the teachers at our school, the faculty at our school, the board for our school, the chairman of the board for our school, for the administrators of our school from the conference. Lord God, you told us all of our children shall be taught of the Lord, and we're trying to do that. And so as we stumble our way along, be, Lord God, our shield and buckler. Be our strong right arm so that we can lean on the everlasting arm of Jesus. We pray for our seniors today, for the hoary heads among us. Thank you, Lord, for their longevity and their wisdom. And we pray that as you anoint them with more wisdom, that our ears will be open to hear, our eyes will be open to see, our hearts will be open to receive, our hands will be open to help, and that our feet will be open to follow. Please, Lord God, draw near to us this day. Remember the families, and we want to pray for husbands and wives today. We want to pray for marriages today. Some are not always in the best place. But Lord, you can fix anything. Yes, you can. And so we pray that you would do a mighty work. And then I want to pray for these single mothers. These grandmothers and mothers who are trying to hold it together. Oh Lord, the winds of strife blow hard. The devil has a roaring lion. Breathes that heavy breath on them. But Lord God, you have a peace that passes understanding. And so, Lord God, may we be able to say, though the storms of life are raging, Jesus is still in charge. Help us to understand that there's nobody like Jesus. Nobody can do it like Jesus. And so, Lord God, today, do for us what we cannot do for ourselves. And we will be careful to give you praise. Is our prayer in the name of Jesus. Amen.